Hey guys, welcome back to Let's Play Mario vs. the Moon Base. Alrighty, head on into Paradise Lagoon. Let's get this world started. Hell yeah! Water World, and we got Fire Flowers. Man, been a while since I played, I'm not gonna lie. Is there like a secret here? Surely that's a death trap, right? Okay, we're just gonna roll with that's a death trap. Anyways, yeah, I absolutely love Water Worlds. Love throwing my fireballs upward on accident. Yeah, I forgot you could do that in this game. Been a while since I've played. Oh wow, check out the little vines down here, little seaweeds. Oh, Blooper, get away from me, man. Don't want to fuck with you right now. What I would like is this power-up. Excellent. And hell, we can even explore above the water, too. There's this nice little area here. Get a fire flower for our efforts. Yeah, why the hell not? Alrighty, moving on. Whoa, that platform totally fell. You get a 1-up. Oh, cool. I just wanted to see if I could go above this land here, but definitely take a 1-up, and it appears I can. Oh wow, cool, there's like a whole little area up here. Excellent. Not sure what that that Koopa Trooper was doing. Probably just sitting there trying to get me to throw the shell around and hurt myself. Excellent, cheap cheap down. Whew. Alrighty, so how you guys doing? Been a while. Appreciate you watching. Thanks for joining me. Hope you're doing well. It is still sweltering here where I live, and yeah, probably everywhere else too. I don't know, nothing else really been going on. Just playing some games, watching some stuff. Normally I run a dual screen monitor setup, and my secondary monitor did die, which is all very sad, so right now I'm just on the solo monitor. I gotta tell you, I don't know what the hell to do with myself with just one monitor, and especially at such a low resolution. I think it's like 1366 by 768, which is tremendously low, but it's an old-ass TV that I don't use anymore, so yeah, what do you expect? Anyways, enough about that. This is really fucking cool. There's this awesome little sunken ship down here. Down in the water in the depths. Okay. And I don't like all the... Well, I do like it, but all these bullet bill cannons are still firing. I wish they weren't still active, but okay. Man. As you can see, whoa! As you can see, there's just so much to explore around. So much went into the environment in this game. And it even has the little warp pipe here for the boss. Oh, well. There's no boss in here, but, you know, like, all the flying ships from Mario 3, they always had these. Oh, it's genius. Alright. Anyways, let's just move on here. Don't want to get nipped by the cheap cheap. Appears we made it out just fine. Past the ship. We don't really need any power-ups or coins. We're doing alright on lives. I really like how Mario Bros. X saves your lives in between plays. It's a great thing to have. Wow. We're in, like, this underground cavern. This is really pretty. The music definitely helps. This is like one of my favorite themes on the N64, like, period. Ugh. There were a lot of really good themes in that on that console, though, I gotta tell you. Can I go up the waterfall? No. Oh well. Oh hey, I can like cheese it there. Ah. Fell down back into the drink. Alright. Going upwards is an interesting mechanic, too. It's nice, but at the same time, you know, I'm not too used to it. That's fine. Up we go. That looks like we're out of the underground cavern. Man, what a beautiful level that was. That was just masterful. Alrighty. Got a fire flower, 4,000 points. Count it. Where the hell are we gonna go now? Yeah, that was definitely a paradise. I love that level. Hidden treasure. Okay, sure. Again, weren't we supposed to be going to a desert area? Did I misread that? Alright, well, it looks like we're on a coin ship. Like, another thing you can get in Mario 3. I don't know, a lot of people know it, but it's not a thing I knew about until spending a lot of time on the internet. Is if you match up your points and coins and, you know, have certain requirements met, you can unlock a giant coin ship that's just filled to the brim with delicious coins we need to collect. It is amazing. Can I dig? Yeah! Mario 2, you know, digging feature going on here. Alright, excellent. Let's just... Oh, shit. Got another ship to worry about? Man. Ah! Just trying to get up. Is that bullet bill gonna fire? Come on. Yeah, there we go. Alright, I wanna explore over here to the left. Let's see what the hell is going on. Oh, yeah. We're gonna kick that Koopa Troopa all over the fucking place. Oh, sir! You alright, buddy? Alright, yeah. Off you go. Man, that was freaky. Lord. Could not have been comfortable for him at all. Oh, looks like the shell's gonna... Oh, we could get a leaf for our efforts, I guess. Like to mix it up here. Alright, off we go. Oh, didn't realize I could fly there. Excellent. Didn't think I had that much momentum gathered. Alright, I would like to get up there, actually. Up above that little brick pyramid there. Not really a pyramid, is it? But, you know, why not? What the hell is going on here? Oh, another thing where I just gotta kick a Koopa shell around. Man, love to- should I kick it in the far left or in the middle? Let's do the far left, why not? Well, I don't know if that was the right decision. It appears I've got a decent amount of coins from it though, so can't complain too much. And I can kind of just dig with my tail if I wanted to. But is this gonna trap me? Oh, that's good. Alright, well let's get the hell out of here. That's enough coins for us. There's probably like a one-up to be gained. Oh, something going on down here too. Oh, that is just awesome, awesome. There's hidden buried gold down here. Wonderful. Alright, out we go. Good thing the Koopa Trooper can't fall down. That would have been a pain in the ass. Get our checkpoint ring. Probably another power up here. Yeah, excellent. Like to keep my fire flower just in case I need to shoot me some fucking fish. You know, stuff like that. Ah, looping music. I wish it didn't loop so hard. That fade out always kills me every time I hear it. Okay. Just whip this guy into shape. Should I go down the pipe or over this way? I think I'm going to go down the pipe. I always prefer going down pipes if I have a choice. Okay. Whoa, what the hell? It is raining Goombas. We are falling to our death. There's some spiny eggs. Man, tons of money here. Oh, sweet. It's raining. Oh, Jesus. As I say, it's raining cheap cheeps as well. Alright, need you to stop camping the pipe there, buddy. Excellent. And we're out of there. Alright. Looks like we're getting into some more sandy territory. Maybe a desert, possibly. It's a nice little gradual transition into what we're going to be dealing with here. Yeah, excellent. There's a lot of hidden treasure in that level. Oh, we had another branching path here, viewers. Dual lakes, or it looks like we have another water level here, Drowned Sea. Let me go ahead and do Drowned Sea and just, because I have this fire flower available, go ahead and use it right now. And let's go get to swimming. Oh man, yeah, this level appears to be like a complete swimming level, possibly. Alright, anyways, can't swim through those blocks, that's interesting. Looper, get out of my face. And we got like Gelectrodes there, I believe that's the name for them. Electric Jellyfish from Mario 3. A lot of Mario 3 in this game, can't complain about that. It's so tough when, you know, if someone were to ask me what my favorite Mario is, like, platformer-wise, I mean, there's so many beautiful Mario games. Honestly, my favorite Mario game where he stars in was probably Mario RPG. But usually when you're asking that question, you're asking, like, you know, which platformer is your favorite? And I really love Super Mario World. Like, I was just playing it recently, and it just still to this day blows my mind. And yes, Mario 3 still blows my mind, but I don't know, for some reason, I just really dig on the Super Mario World. But definitely love Mario 3. Hell, I love them all, honestly. Mario 2, though, was really different, is incredibly fuck you, Piranha Plant, incredibly fun for me. Even though it's like, it's actually really still to this day pretty challenging for me. And of course you have the classic Mario Brothers. I suck ass at lost levels. I'll probably never play that again. I don't know, whenever I feel particularly cocky or feel I need to be beaten into shape, I'll play some lost levels. And of course, there's countless others as well. Hell, I even like, you know, Super Mario Sunshine is also one of my favorites. It gets a lot of shit, you know, people tend to hate that game. But Sunshine rocks my freaking socks, man. I could play that game any day. And what else? I love Luigi's Mansion, and oh, I could just go on forever and ever. The whole Mario franchise, just, I totally have a boner for him. No joke. Then again, you guys probably have gathered that much. Alright, yeah, looks like we're at a level. Managed to bullshit my way through that, no problem at all. Alright, where are we going to be heading from here? Is that these glaciers going on? Yeah, Snowy Island, alright. Or Isle, excuse me. Well, let's go ahead and... Oh, this music is so wonderful. Speaking of Super Mario RPG. Oh, shit. I'd like to keep my flight ability. Fuck it. No, yeah. We're gonna keep the flight ability, and now we're throwing snowballs! Yeah, we have an ice flower here, excuse me. And that will allow us to freeze enemies. You can pick up the ice blocks, throw them around. Yeah, I knew I should have kept that fire flower. I was seeing blocks I could have melted with that thing. But oh well. Ice flower is still a lot of fun. Especially, you can just easily cheese enemies like that and use them as projectiles. Yes, die! Ah, being able to throw any direction is really fun too. And I could be playing as Luigi in this game. It's pretty much just a Mario-Luigi game. However, I don't know, I just kind of want to stick with Mario. It's been working out well for me. Don't really need to change things up here. On some of the other games, you can play as, like, Link and Peach. But yeah, Not this one, just Mario Luigi. Alright, nothing we can really melt here. The dragon coin way the hell up there, which is kind of interesting. I take this ice block with me. Oh! No, but I can break his face up against the pipe there. Oh, looks like we're gonna get ourselves an ice Yoshi as well. I'm assuming that's what this guy does. Again, not too familiar with the Yoshi's abilities in Mario Bros. X. Well, that really doesn't count, does it? That was a fire shell. Oh, that one didn't give me ice power either. Well, we'll just have to explore around with this, see what the hell it does. Surely there's like a life in one of these, right? Nope, wasted my time. Well, alright, fair enough, game. Don't need to re-up our ice flower, that would be ridiculous. Yes! Okay, he does spit out ice. I thought so. Alright, get a little bit of dosh here. Grab it while it's hot. Ice. And, oh, we can't slide on Yoshi. That is sad, Panda Day. Alright, up we go. Should be done with this level. Yeah, that would have been pretty dangerous to harvest those coins. Those munchy plants down there. I can never remember the name of those. I've known the name at some point in time. Never freaking remember. And I am getting, like, consistent flower power-ups. Not power-ups, but flower cards there at the end of the level. It's a bit odd. Alright, well, looks like we may be able to wrap the levels around and connect them here. So why don't we hit up Dual Lakes, see what the hell's going on here. Bringing my Yoshi with me, why not? Yeah, I'd prefer to have this fire flower, actually. Ah, we lost our raccoon leaf, but that's okay. In case we lose our Yoshi, we'll have this nice... Whoa! We'll have this nice fire flower to rely on. What the hell's up here? Probably some lives? Ah, multiple coin block, and... Yes! Give me your delicious one-up town. Oh, and there's that music again. Seriously, put me to sleep. It probably has at some point in time. Alright, let's follow this ice block down here. Why not? I love that you can see, like, these giant pipes in the background, too. It's a really nice touch. Got my face cheap. You bother me. Ooh. There's, like, plant life hanging from the ceiling. Oh, it's just so expertly crafted. I'm really loving this project, I gotta say. And I love that I can pick the, you know, the ice block that I just shot out, you know. Use it again. Ah, ha, ha. Grab it. And drop it. Excellent. What is going on here? It looks like a pretty basic level design. You know, just dodging cheeps and stuff. Enjoying the atmosphere. Grab some coins if you like. Nothing to really worry about here. Kind of a nice casual swim through the dual lakes. Wait, wasn't that only one lake? Oh. What the hell? Didn't expect this to be down here. Alright, well that's strange. Get rid of our ice flower, why not? I prefer fire flowers pretty much on any other occasion. Alrighty, well I didn't expect like a pipe situation going on here. Whoa! We got Goomba generator. Ugh, I love those Goomba generators, seriously. Oh, this is a little bit dangerous, isn't it? Alright, let's be a little bit methodical here. No problem at all! Koopa Shell, Yoshi, you are not leaving me today, sir. Sorry. Well, you may, but... Oh yeah, here's the second lake, okay. So you had that nice little underground area to connect the two. Wow. Mind-blowing. Alright. Let's just keep swimming here. Not doing any work. All of our Yoshi is just simply doing literally everything for us. You know, he's doing the swimming, he's doing the killing, doing the eating. I'm just kind of chilling, enjoying the nice ride. All I have to do is hold my breath. Man, Italians sure can hold their breath for extremely long periods of time. Have you ever noticed that? It's pretty crazy. Alrighty. And up we go. Looks like we may finally be done here. Yeah, that was really nice. The water levels in this game, they're a little... I don't want to say slow, that's just kind of how water levels typically are. They're really well made, I don't know, I'm really enjoying it. Oh hey, these didn't actually connect here, uh-oh. Well that's a problem. The locker, ooh, I like the sound of that. Or we could head to this red level. This will have multiple exits for us, let's go ahead and do it. Peer pressure, nice little play on words there, alright. Got this wonderful music going on here. Seems a little strange for this particular area, but that's fine. Let's just see how fast we can do things here. And also, keep in mind, viewers, we need to keep an eye out for a secret exit as well. So, if you see anything suspicious, feel free to shout at your monitor, and maybe somehow you'll travel through time and be able to tell me, hey, the secret's over there, you asshole. Hey, and there's something over there to the left. Huh. I wonder if I can't reach over there without a tail. Ah! If I could bring a Yoshi up there, I could. Maybe we should keep an eye out for a raccoon tail then. Until then, let's explore what's over here on this right area. Oh, just a dragon coin and a P-switch. Now why the hell is there a P-switch here? Oh, wait. I'm thinking I remember something here. Because remember, I have played through this. That's right, the desert level isn't here. We're in, like, the water level. Desert level's next. Anyway, spoilers. I seem to remember something here with the P-switch. And that I need to go back to the left. There's actually something way over here at the start. That needs to be P-switched. Yeah, like, way the hell back. Yes! This thing right here. Excellent. Oh, no, you get back your P-switch. Oh, I just almost crapped my pants. Alright. What the hell's going on here? We have, oh, okay, apparently there's a hidden block there. That's good to know, I guess. We got the bombs going on, and we got, that's gonna block the keyhole off, isn't it? Okay, well, fair enough. Maybe I can enter, yes, I can probably enter this pipe over here. Yeah, to get over here to the right. Alright, excellent. So all we need to do is just find that key, and then we will have the secret exit to this level all figured out. Where go, bomb? No! Okay, we're fine. Not sure what kind of sound that was, but it was a sound. Alright, pick up the key. Can Yoshi eat these and hold it? Yes, excellent. Now let's just go ahead and swim up this waterfall, which is another feature I really love. Love swimming up waterfalls. And we should be out of here. Can I do like the Super Mario World where I like do a little dance while I'm going through the keyhole if you're on Yoshi? Okay. And that opened up, a pipe. Where does this pipe lead to? World 4 warp pipe? Seriously? World 4? Whoa, spoilers! Ah, close your eyes, viewers, you saw nothing. Alright, let me take a proper look here. Piranha Jungle. If we can't get to this particular level in World 4 through just, you know, standard level unlocking, then we'll come back here through the warp pipe. For now, let's get the regular exit on peer pressure. Now I should be able to just run through without having to worry about a damn thing. Excellent. Koopa Troopa. Can't really fuck with you. Oh! Yoshi. Well, he did stomp a guy while I was getting hit, so can't be too mad at him. And, you know, ultimately, I am in control of this fucking horse, so why not? Yeah, I don't like Yoshi again. I've said it before. You know, I did like Yoshi on Super Mario Sunshine, though, because all he did the whole game was projectile vomit fucking everywhere, which is beautiful to watch. Alright. That level actually really short if you're not doing the secret exit. Damn, where the hell am I going now? Up here? Surely this will wrap around the alternate path. Operation Seaweed. Don't know if I necessarily like the sound of that. Alright, fire flowers. Yeah, we already have a wealth of those. So we're gonna have a lot of seaweed going. Ooh! Alright, Yoshi. You're dead to me, sir. Let's see what this does. Oh! Yes. Now we can, like, break through blocks and shit like that with ease. It's basically like just having a melee weapon with you, honestly. You can just kill anything, break through blocks. It is a wonderful thing to have my disco pipe in my hand. With my blue piranha plant. I guess if they're blue plants, they're friendly. I don't know. Has that been established? Oh, and I can even take it down with me. Excellent. And I like the little Super Metroid item pedestal. Oh, what the hell? Is that an actual shark? Don't remember any of those in any Mario games, and I'm sure someone will correct me. I remember sharks in Super Mario Land 2, I think. But those were like fake cardboard sharks with like motors on their backs in the backside. I'm sure someone will correct me, and I welcome that, honestly, because my brain is not, you know, that great, and I love to hear people talk about awesome video games that I love, and help me learn about awesome video games that I love. Alright, anyways, yeah, without this thing in my hand, this would be, well, hell, it'd probably be impossible. That just made that super easy, and also a lot of fun. Alright, down we go. Yeah, we're just gonna float all the way down. You're gonna try and kick that shell at me. It's not gonna work out too well for you, buddy. I was trying to eat it with my little piranha pipe. Piranha pipe? I like the sound of that. Okay, why not? This is the piranha pipe. Alright, anyways. Down we go. Ah, wow. Looks like we're gonna have, like, maybe a vertical segment here. Yep. Just dodging these guys. You kind of have... Get the fuck out of here. You kind of have a hard time slowing down on your upward ascent. So be a little bit careful, you know, so you don't swim into piranha plants. Alright. Ah! Definitely needed that. Didn't want to lose any lives here. Okay. Whoa, shit! Oh man, I'm trying to go too fast and I'm getting reamed for, you know, my shit, get rid of it! Sorry, I lost my train of thought there. Yeah, I was getting reamed for just not being careful. Oh, definitely don't bring that thing with you if you're trying to get that one up there. Okay, now we're gonna head over to a battleship level. I'm gonna go ahead and head down into the locker. I don't have any power-ups though, so this may be a little bit scary. And also, I don't have my recorder countdown timer going on, so I don't know how long I've been recording. Oh. Whoa. This just got really scary, didn't it? So we're on like underwater ghost ship situation, maybe? From the looks of these blocks and the coins, that appears to be the case. This music is actually really scary. Anyways, let's just get the hell out of here. I don't like this place. Ugh. A lot of sharks. Yeah, we got booze. Okay, so this is an undead underwater adventure for us. I want to go down that pipe down there. We have to get 2 coins to go in there. That's kind of weird. Anyways, down we go. And into the pipe. I'm a little nervous as to what is going to be ahead. Alright, so we're actually in the ship. Great levels. Ow! Whoa, fuck, man! Super Metroid turrets? That's not right, is it? Come on. Or I guess they'd just be Metroid turrets. They were in the original one as well. Oh! Look! Oh, dick move game. Invisible coin blocks always beat the piss out of me. Alright, but that's fine. Those really weren't, like, obscenely placed, like, just trying to piss me off. That was actually a pretty interesting coincidence that I happened to hit those. Also, these fucking donut beams are really terrible to dodge, too. Praying for a power-up up here. Thank you. It's going the wrong way, but we should be able to get it while I'm in bullet hell here. Ah! Okay, we're fine. Making some horrible noises this episode. I apologize. That boo is really fast. Good lord. Difficulty. Out of nowhere. What the hell? Oh, give me that midpoint. Is this going to turn me large when I hit it? Yes, it is. What the hell? Oh, screw you, game. That's malicious. And here we go, underwater lava segment. What the hell is with these invisible blocks everywhere? It's making me nervous, man. I never know when I'm gonna hit them. Alright, definitely like this, excellent. And let's be careful of all this underwater fire. Whoa, underwater fire is killing themselves. It's kind of amusing. Alright, carefully dodge this boo here. This radial boo. Radial boo technology. Can I go through these actual, like, wooden planks? I can. Excellent. That fire was coming for me. It killed the boo, which makes me the happiest man alive. Alright, back up to Big Mario here. Damn, I'm gonna have to go under this one. This is just crazy town. Alright, swim faster, Mario. Good lord, get out of here. This is gonna be tough to dodge, too. Okay. Yeah, there we go. Not really too tough, but for my amateur skill set, yeah, it was a little difficult. Alrighty. Am I gonna have to fight like a boss here or something? I hope not. Let's go ahead and just see. Okay, what is this guy? Is that Hotfoot from Super Mario 2? Something like that. So we're gonna need to throw shells into Hotfoot here. Like so. This really shouldn't be too difficult. As long as I don't hit myself with my own shells. He seems... Whoa! Or just knock my own projectiles out of here. He seems pretty damn slow. He'll probably speed up when I hit him some more. Which is okay, I guess. Doesn't seem too bad. Again, wasting projectiles like a fool bag. I like how he pushes the shell around down there. That's interesting. Alrighty, there you go. Fireballs don't hurt him, but, you know, that's probably a good thing, as he is a giant ember. He's underwater, too. How the hell is this working? Never mind. Just Mario magic. That's all you need to know. He appears to be speeding up? I'm not sure if that's just in my head or he is actually speeding up. I think it's actually just in my head. Okay. Hey, nice. I was worried my fireball would kill my shell, but nothing to worry about there. I did kill that one, though. That sucked. How many hits do you take, Hotfoot? This is getting a little ridiculous. Oh, shit. He may be speeding. Oh! My shell got in the whoa! He, like, almost pushed me out of the level there. That was kind of weird. Oh, whatever. Back up to our Big Mario, and yeah! That's a really good spot to hit him, is when he's ascending up here, you can get multiple hits on him. I like the Metroid death animation there, too. Wonderful. We're done. Should I keep recording? Again, I don't know the length of the video. Let's see where the hell we're going next. We still have... Oh, actually, we're wrapped around... Oh! What the hell is this? A coin ship! Ooh, bonus level! I do like my bonus levels. Hey, hey, Yoshi's Island birds! How's it going? The derp birds. I love those guys, seriously. Yeah, this should be a nice casual romp. Just collect coins, nothing to worry about here. Well, if it's anything like the coin ships of my past. However, you are gonna have to be a little bit careful you don't get scrolled off the screen. Otherwise, really nothing too much to worry about. You're getting a decent amount of lives. I wonder if we'll have 99 by the end of this. Again, I really don't know how long this project is. Wonderful! Up and at 'em! Get the coinage. Sweet. Hey, we got a little springboard here. Sweet. How many dragon coins do I have? I wish I had an on-screen indicator. Then I'd probably want to collect them a little bit more. Alright, can I get all of these without dying? I don't think so. What? What happened? I squished myself? Alright, yeah, be the hell careful. Apparently you can just squish yourself in the Super Mario Bros. X engine. Damn, I had no idea. I was trying to like slide under it to give me a higher chance to collect more coinage. But what the hell can you do? Alright, oh that's cute. There's like a little coin sale on the top there. Excellent. We got that. Got a few lives there. I did lose a life, but whatever. Random ice flower is random. Random fire flower is random. Are you gonna give me anything else? A mushroom? Okay, that's like a weird power-up generator there. And probably something amazing. I was expecting like a one-up to come out at the very last second. Alright, well we're done with the coin ship. Why don't we just swim to land here and be done with this weird-ass level. Yeah, I'm really loving these designs. Excellent, there is the exit. However, we are now stranded on this island forevermore. Ugh. Wilson! There we go. Not Wilson from, like, Home Improvement, but, you know, volleyball. Alright, so we'll do one last level here. Pirate Armada, and then we'll probably call it, I don't know, 30 lives. Pirate Armada, we got a toad freaking the hell out. Oh! Wendy-O Pirate, Wendy-O's Pirate Armada is on its way to invade the bay. You've got to stop her. Excellent. So yeah, Wendy-O, this should be the last level for this whole World 2 level set. Excellent. So how are we going to stop Wendy-O? Well, we're going to jump into the water, just swim up to her fucking ships, and murder her. Man, sounds really intense if you think about it. This plumber just jumps into the water, swimming at the ships, jumps on board, starts shooting fireballs at all the creatures, takes down an entire armada, all by his lonesome. Wonderful. Hey there, Mr. Mole, Monty Mole guy. Get out of here. You're not a Monty Mole, though, are you? You're like a... I can't remember what your names are. Huh. Interesting. Anyways. Oh, I was gonna slide under, but that would've killed me. Pay attention there, Alan. Good lord. Up we go. So far, this isn't too bad. Seriously, what the hell are the names of those guys? That really bothers me. Wrench. Wrench. Wrenchy Joes. No, that's not it. I don't know. Oh, Koopa Troopa. Get out of here. These ships are floating different. It's kind of making me a little seasick, honestly. What if I can get on the roof of that one there? Here's that I can. Let's see here. You gonna have enough time? Oh, Koopa Troopa. I gotta take hard mode down here, but even hard mode really isn't that hard. This game. Oh, the wrench got me. Damn. Here I was talking. Talking mess! Yep, see what happens. Hubris. Alrighty, well, I made it up onto the ceiling this time. So. Well, I have to take that, you know, hard path down there. What did I learn from, you know, the off-camera work that I just did? Well, I learned that birds will just fuck your shit up, apparently, if you touch them. And also, you can't spin jump on these wrench-throwing dudes, so that is unfortunate. Can't, well, I wonder if you could spin jump on a cheap jeep. Really don't feel like trying. Oh, Mario, you fell, but no problem here. Now we're on the ladder ship. Excellent. I already made up for that lost life by getting a ton of coins. Excellent. Oh, wow. What's going on down here? Probably get another power up. Yeah, sweet. They will die to fireballs though, and that is all that I need from them is to die. Die horrible, horrible deaths. Okay. More bullet bill launchers, no problem. We probably getting close to the end of this, I would hope. I haven't hit any checkpoint rings. Oh shit. Which is a little strange, but you know, whatever. It happens, I guess. Maybe they don't want any checkpoints because this oh shit! Because this is a boss level or something. Alright. Get another fire flower here, probably. Yeah, nothing to worry about. They're really... Come on! That thing hit me twice! They're really generous with the power-ups in this project, so that's nice. Alright. Whoa. Ha! Almost got me there, buddy. Anything over here to the right? Doesn't appear to be. Let's go fight Wendy. Why the hell not? If I died at her... Oh! Hey, there's a checkpoint ring. Sweet. Oh, it's right before the boss, too. What friendly design that is. So in case I die to her, I don't have to do the whole level again. That is really pleasant. Oh my god. She's throwing rings with the quickness here. I can't seem to jump on her and hit her. I mean, I know there's an axe right there, but... Oh, it is doing damage. Okay. I was gonna say... I try not to do the axe thing if I don't have to, like in Super Mario, you know, Super Mario Brothers. Always try and do the fireball method. Excellent. Alright, I like that you can still collect the axe, just in case, I don't know, you still want to use it. Why the hell not? Well, that should wrap up today's episode. We've cleared out an entire world. Yes, there's World 3 there, the desert world. And from here on out, we are going to be playing blind, so this will be really fun. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time. Take care, guys.